Algae form the basis of the huge ecosystem hidden beneath the surface of the water. Most are planktonic microscopic algae, also known as phytoplankton, and there are many different species which play various roles in the ecosystem, including as food for zooplankton, which in turn are eaten by fish. Phytoplankton are also important for the climate. They convert carbon dioxide into oxygen through photosynthesis and are just as important as forests and other plants on land, producing around half of our planet's oxygen. Algae need light, water, and nutrients to grow. Spring is the peak season, when there is plenty of light and nutrients have been transported to the surface through the deep water mixing during the winter. Spring blooms of phytoplankton begin in the illuminated surface layer, using the nutrients found there. The most spectacular algal bloom in the Baltic Sea, both offshore and in the archipelago, is the cyanobacteria bloom, or blue-green algae as it was previously called. Cyanobacteria thrive in the brackish Baltic water, and can utilize nitrogen gas dissolved in the seawater, unlike other phytoplankton. Eutrophication is a major problem in the Baltic Sea. This means the nutrient input is too high, leading to unusually large cyanobacteria blooms, which affect the entire ecosystem. These blooms can even be seen from space. The countries surrounding the Baltic Sea are working together to reduce the problem. Some of the algae sink to the seabed. In the deep basins of the Baltic Sea, in Laholm Bay and in some of the fjords of the Bohus coast, this leads to low oxygen conditions when the algae are broken down by bacteria. Another problem is that some algae produce toxins which can accumulate in mussels and oysters, which live on phytoplankton. Eating these mussels can make people seriously ill. Phytoplankton and algal blooms are the foundation for marine ecosystems. Some might cause problems, but fish and other animal life would be unable to live without phytoplankton. SMHI carries out research so we can learn more about phytoplankton. SMHI also collects samples from research vessels of both phytoplankton and zooplankton as part of Sweden's national environmental monitoring.